V.S. Raghuram, the president of the FAPC, to give the welcome address. Shri V.S. Raghuram.
Dr. Hanuman Chaudhary Garu, Chairman, Kanna Bharati, Mr. M.R. Venkatesh, economist, communist, and author, Shri Thirumalai, management consultant, economist, and past president of the Federation of Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Dr. Somra Susila, president, social cause, Mr. Devendra Surana, our senior vice president, S. Kumar, deputy secretary general, past presidents and management committee members, members of the FAPC, distinguished guests and invitees, ladies and gentlemen, and also electronic media. Very good evening to all of you. I am extremely happy to welcome you all for today's important seminar on American Debt Crisis, Lessons for the World. My special welcome to Sri M.R. Venkatesh, economist, columnist and author, and Mr. Thirumalai, a management consultant, economist, and past president of the Federation of Chamber of Commerce and Industry. The downgrading of the U.S. government's debt credit rating by the rating agency Standard & Poor's has added new challenges to the Indian financial market. As the country's economy is facing the threat of slower GDP growth in the current financial year, industry is reeling under high rate of interest costs, inflation is ruling high, and the stock prices are at their 14-month low. Trouble in the U.S. economy adds new dimensions. As one of the 15 largest foreign creditors to the U.S., India's exposure to the United States ballooning debts is estimated at US$41 billion. The overall national debt of the U.S. is moving nearer to $15 trillion, out of which it owes over US dollars of $4.5 trillion to foreign countries holding U.S. government debt securities. While China is the single largest beneficiary holder of the U.S. Treasury bonds of ₹1.15 trillion, India stands at 14th position, about 1,83 crores, as per the U.S. Treasury Department data. While the unprecedented downgrading of the U.S. Treasury bonds may lower the value of RBI's holding, the central bank will not be able to switch its reserves to other currencies or to any other form of assets quickly. Some experts feel that the RBI may continue to hold U.S. bonds even with a notch lower rating, as it has been self-amassing the U.S. Treasury securities over the past 1 year despite the deepening debt crisis there. The Indian holding has grown up by about $10 billion in the past 1 year. As 60% of India's $60 billion software exports is targeted to the U.S. clients, their weak financials will hamper demand. According to TPI data, already large IT and BPO's outsourcing deals in U.S. market were down by 50% in the 6 months, January to June 2011. Exporters are worried that the debt crisis in the Western world will hit the demand and to lead to the payments problem. Europe and U.S. account for a third of India's exports. The exporters are expressing concern whether to accept orders coming from the U.S. and the European Union. There's a probability that those might be cancelled midstream, or our buyers may not be in a position to pay us after receiving the goods. In the background of the crisis in the two regions, it is necessary that the government of India should extend tax offs and other incentives to the exporters. And it was told mostly the exports from the German jewelries, garments, leather garments have been much more affected apart from the IT sector. Industry believes that it is the right time for the RBI to move ahead of the curve and cut the rates. After all, India could use the current global economic turmoil to its own advantage, just that it withstood the perils of 2008 crisis. It may be noted that cut in interest rates would have boosted corporate India's confidence and image, which has taken a hit. Last but not least, we need to emphasize the importance of implementing next phase of structural reforms. Without progress in reforms, investment sentiment will not improve and an opportunity will be missed. I am sure the presence of eminent personalities like Mr. M.R. Venkatesh and Mr. Tirumalai would provide the valuable inputs and greater ideas that would benefit your business the most and devise the strategy for you to use. Thank you. Once again, thank you all.